Keith Coben here, and you are?
My name's Dean Severs, and I'd like to welcome you to the 20th anniversary commemorative vintage cart reunion.
So how this the groupings are going to start out for the day. Historic, so carts to 1962 with engines to 1962, but we grandfathered the Mac 49 engine to put it up about the same power. After that, rear engine carts. After that, duels. We're going to do rear duels and dual sidewinders. Sidewinder guys group in the front and go out first, and we'll send the rear duels behind them. Then American Reed sidewinder. So if you had a Bender or a Mac on a sidewinder, that's your group. Then the last group is Yamaha and foreign sidewinder. So you guys run together. I have a feeling as the day wears on, we'll probably be consolidating the groups. And what we'll probably end up with is three groups, which will be all rear engine carts, all duels, all sidewinders. But let's try and, at least for the morning, to space it out and do this. After that, there will be open track session. And then after that, we're having a closed session for juniors and novices. And included in novices is if you have a vintage cart that's got a four-stroke on it, you can go out with the juniors and novices group. So we'll be out on the track. And then Richard Kennedy, when he feels moved to do so, will treat us to a show. After that, then we start that cycle again. And we just run that through the day until 12:30. We shut the track down for lunch. If you're participating, we're feeding you. If you don't like what we're serving, or if you're spectating, there will be a food truck here from 11 to 3. We have really good tacos. And then after that, we'll start this again until 5 o'clock, shut her down, and then we'll have show award trophies and raffles. Last thing of the day is raffling off the cart, and then we'll send y'all home. So I appreciate you being here. Have fun. Stay safe.
Today with Terry Ives of Granite Bay, California, and he is someone that keeps the vast majority of the people out here running in karting and vintage karting. And
yes.
Terry, why don't you tell us a little bit about your history in this activity?
I started the sport in 1958. I enjoyed it. Okay. I stuck with it all my life through the military, through working for the military, and in retirement.
Sounds like we finally got some prizes.
Work on the cart stuff and keep people going.
Beautiful.
Yeah, and one thing that we've always we've come to expect you always being at every race. You bring this van here with all your equipment, and you're a very busy guy at the track, and we always appreciate it. Keeping us running and actually teaching us a lot of stuff too, because a lot of us are, you know, new to the mechanical side of it, and not only do you fix our stuff, but you kind of tell us what you're doing and give us advice, and a lot of it's no charge, which is pretty nice. And tell us a little bit about your history as a racer before you were like just doing mechanical stuff.
Well, we all want to be competitive, and early in life you think you can be as good as the next person, so you try and you strive. There's a lot involved, and you learn the mechanics of it, you learn how to financially afford it, and you make a lot of mistakes on your way, and you learn by that. So that's where we're at today. We're trying to explain to people how not to make the mistakes that we made, so
yeah,
make a shortcut for them.
Mm-hmm. Have you in your racing background, what was it like being a racer back in the 60s compared to like a modern racing setup now?
Well, back in the 60s and stuff, we raced for the passion of racing. And it's like anything. You want to be competitive. You want to be as good as the next guy. So today it's all about the money backing the racing, and it's pretty much lost the passion, and it's more of a business. So, yeah, you got to be careful with where you're going today because it can be very expensive and not get the rewards that you're looking for. So,
understood. So back in the 60s when you were, late 50s and 60s, when you're, you know, in the beginning of your racing career, what did the pits look like? Was it filled with motorhomes and box trailers like we see now at a, you know, modern karting event, or was it different?
Back in the day, you were lucky to have a vehicle to get your stuff to the track. So
number panel, NASA panel.
Anyway, the transport vehicle was anything that had four wheels and would move. So,
and a really cool new gym.
It wasn't too sophisticated, but today it's all about how much equipment you have and stuff, and it has nothing to do with the ability to drive fast. So,
225.
There's nothing like seat time.
Yeah. Is that a big difference?
Yeah. Back in the day, we had respect for each other. It was a big thing. Today there is no respect. It's all about how you can knock people off the racetrack, and that's why you have all the bumpers and the body work and all that.
Okay,
kind of
ladies.
Stuff. So, that part
Tom
of it
Wilms,
has changed a lot.
For the girls.
What they don't realize is that the racetracks are the same width as they were 60 years ago. Mm-hmm. So, the only way you can pass is by knocking them out of your way.
You probably know a girl.
Well, you can do that with pool. I just don't believe in being
a
billiard ball.
Tell me about that Volkswagen that you had to go to and from the races back in the day.
Well, a Volkswagen when I was in the service is what I could afford.
085.
The only way to get a go-kart in there was to take the back seat and the passenger seat out and turn the cart sideways and put it in there. We went all over the country like that.
Yeah.
What was nice about that is when the car broke down, you usually steal some parts off the go-kart to keep the car running.
Might even have a push-up bra on.
That's funny. It seemed like you're working on stuff from literally all over the world. I mean, South America. It seems like you're building engines. You have customers from all over. Is that the case? I mean, people are still interested in this old stuff?
Well, they're interested in the old stuff because that is vintage. That is old time. And that's what they remember having fun doing.
Mm-hmm.
So they like to keep their old stuff running. So what we've been doing is buying up old chainsaws and stuff to keep the parts supply in the loop. So we make a lot of stuff now that we can't get. So that's how we keep everybody going.
820 expansion pipe.
Nice.
And originally how karting started was they had a bunch of West Bends for lawnmowers, and they didn't sell real well. And Coretta decided to put one on one of their carts that they made around the Rose Bowl.
It's large, Tim Meyer.
The sport caught on because it was so much fun sitting on something that close to the ground, going that fast, and not hurting anybody. So, yeah, it's great stuff. So, Lou Borelli is really one of the guys that was, guilty of starting the sport, and I happened to stumble into that. I used to work at a Baskin-Robbins ice cream place when I was going through high school.
Did they even say that?
Walking home from work one day, and I saw this yellow thing sitting on a green lawn, and I didn't recognize it. I couldn't figure out what kind of lawnmower it was, and I asked the fellow who was in the front yard, and he said, well, that's a go-kart. I said, what the heck's a go-kart?
So congratulations.
He explained to me it was just a hobby.
Mm-hmm.
So I had been fooling around with skateboards down the beach and stuff. And so I picked up my interest because we moved inland, and I kept it for my parents, so we had a great time with it.
Well, that's awesome. Well, just wanted to say thank you very much for all you do for us in this hobby and keeping us running. And yeah. So what do you think of the event this weekend for the turnout? Was it a pretty good one?
I think you and Dean Seavers did a hell of a heck of a job, Kevin.
No, thank you.
I know how much work it takes to keep things going. So without your enthusiasm and pushing this and going through all the trials and tribulations.
The rules are from China.
Dealing with who knows what.
Yeah.
So.
Well, yeah, at the end of the day, it's like a big party. You send out invitations and you hope a lot of people come. And it seemed like it was pretty successful.
It's all about the fun factor and it's about the people.
Yeah.
Those two guys.
Yeah, that's where I think that a lot of the new generation is missing out. So.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, hope we're, you know, one of the things, the takeaways from this, we're hoping that we get, you know, if we get some new vintage Carters out of this, that'd be a win. And that's, you know, to try and grow the hobby a little bit. And, yeah. So we'll keep our fingers crossed.
Well, it's been very enjoyable this weekend.
209 wins the tire.
John and Donald have been very accommodating, allowing us to rip up their racetrack and have a good time. And,
209.
They're in business to make money and a living, so we appreciate them allowing us the time they did. So
certainly.
Glad you and Dean spearheaded this whole thing.
Dean talked him into it.
Well, it took a lot of talking, believe me. It wasn't an easy thing.
Yeah. Well, awesome. Okay, well, that's about everything I have. So, yeah, I want to say thank you very much.
Well, you're welcome, Keith, and thank you.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
Just because we get around.
Talking about my generation.
Things ain't doing awful. I die before I get old. Try and dig what we all say. I'm not trying to cause a big sensation.
I'm
just talking about my generation. We all
we'll be right back. Okay.
My hitching dad, that's why he came over here.
Ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, get those red tickets out, and I've got 10.
Does the ticket match?
It sure does.
Wow.
We got a wiener chicken dinner.
Sleep in the seat.
I didn't bring my truck.
That's cool. Let's go drive your twin.
This means that there'll always be a vintage group here on just regular weekends.
What you're getting here is that the 20th anniversary, more or less.
Yeah.
COVID made it more like the 21st or 2nd anniversary. Yeah. I know this had to be rescheduled a couple of times because of the pandemic.
Right.
But so I'm understanding you that the reason it's at this track is this is the first track that really let vintage carts on it.
Right.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, if it wasn't for Prairie City, I don't know that vintage karting would have gotten off the ground.
Yeah. Well, that's great. Overall, how do you think the event is going to go today, or how do you think?
Oh, I thought it's great. I mean, it's fantastic. I've seen people today that I haven't seen in 15 years. And so it's kind of mission accomplished.
Yeah. Would you say one of the goals of the event is, we have the regulars that come out to everything, but is one of the goals to maybe get people, back into it that have been out of it for a while, perhaps?
Yeah. I mean, I think it was to get them out today. And then with the hope that they had such a good time that they'll kind of, it'll rekindle interest and they'll become active in karting again, vintage karting. We just got video bombed.
Wise guy. Yeah. Awesome. Well, as an attendee here, I had a great time and I think everyone else did. There had to be, if you added up all the carts that were, in the big group photo and what was out in the pits, I'd say there were 100 carts.
That's really cool.
Yeah. And, a lot of drivers, and yeah, so I'm proud to have been involved with it. So I just want to say good job. And it's a one and done event, but I think it was absolutely outstanding. And I've heard nothing but kudos and good things about it.
Well, so. I appreciate your help. Without your help, this wouldn't have happened. So Keith was my guardrails.
Well, we have a lot of fun doing this. So.
Yeah,
all right. Cool. Well, thanks, Dean.
Yeah, thanks, Keith. Yeah. Appreciate it.
All right. Oh, give me the beat, boys, and free my soul. Oh,